I'm with Krishna Chokhani of Chokhani Group. This is the next gen. With me, he's going to tell us more about the NBFCs that Chokhani Group runs. He's also going to talk to me about the family office that the Chokhani Group is running and about how he's looking to diversify the business model to a unique one. He claims it's a unique one. We'll hear more from him. In your family office, what kind of investments are you doing? We're seeing family offices taking a great flight in India, keeping in mind the businesses, big businesses like yours, realize the need to invest in something more than just real estate and gold. How has your experience been?
So experience is actually very good, especially with the digital shift that's coming in. A lot of disruptive technologies taking over family-owned traditional businesses. So typically I've seen is a lot of family businesses are feeling left out because either of lack of knowledge, lack of expertise, or old mindsets and old principles set up by the previous generation. As new generation, we are more risk averse. We like exploring into new things, and it's good to be backed by a family because there is still some runway that we can use or burn in order to grow.
Sure.
So that's what we are looking at. There are multiple things that we did traditionally. So I'm a Marwadi. So as Marwadis, we are known to be the money lenders of India.
Right.
So that's how traditionally, three generations back, my grandfather's father had started his initial business by lending money to various Marwadi community people.
I see.
Slowly, slowly, we built up towards investing into market products.
I see.
Then we started moving to gold, real estate, as you rightly mentioned. We made it into debt products in India and globally. Technology investment actually started back in 2008 by my father because of one of my his close friends did the first e-tax filing company of the country. That's where he invested and made a handsome return, and that's where he pushed me to start looking towards technology.
So what are you doing in that? You start your NBFCs?
So we typically operate our investments through an NBFC for the efficiency of a structure, but we at the moment are looking at technology which are first financially handsomely returning us the money, trying to see how safely we can help them grow, and as well as incorporate them within our systems, and then we see about how they are going to globally impact other sectors where we may be left out in case we don't diversify. FinTech obviously has been the main focus till now. Lending money has been the main focus. We just see what kind of a balance sheet it is and then start lending money without focusing on sectors. But yes, obviously going back now, even entrepreneurs or borrowers have become smart.
Sure.
They need money from strategic people who can actually help them grow, not just give them money. They need strategic investors, not financial investors anymore.
Sure.
So that's where we see where we have expertise, where we have network, where our fathers, forefathers have built their name, goodwill, and start using those companies to get them and leverage our network for their benefit as well.
You're looking at investments in the global ecosystem also. You're looking to get some technology into India?
Yes, yes. So the we are in a globalized world, obviously. India has a limitation on technology and talent.
Sure.
So we cannot get everything in India. So something like agri-tech is good in India, but there's not too much of innovation. So that's where we start stepping out to better places like Israel, where we get to see so many innovative technologies. They increase yields by 10 times with a very mere investment just because of their research that they've done over years, where we lack in. So that's where we are looking to start investing into those kind of companies.
The pace that you picked up for family offices, are you also looking to inspire other big families to set up a shop? And do you see this as a phenomena happening in big family or businesses?
Yes, so you must have seen the big families like Jio's, just a very big example. It's all over India. These guys have suddenly shifted from traditional businesses to digital businesses in no time.
Right.
So obviously there are a lot of people in the tier 2 HNI category, ultra HNI category family offices who have no clue of what's going on.
Do you think that the disruption of tomorrow is going to be created by the Gen X leaders of our family offices and family businesses?
That's true, partly. Yes, they will give platform to new technology to grow faster, not only with their money but with their networks. But yes, disruption will only come in when new next gen starts diversifying, starts innovating, has a more open mind and not just be stuck. A lot of Indian families are just stuck to their business because it's doing well. But you need to have a foresight, and that's what we are trying to build. Have a foresight for the next 50 years, 100 years. Not only help families or your business to grow, but help your environment also to improve.